is News at 6.
It's horrible. It's totally devastating. This is just totally not cool.
Experts think a deadly dinner may have just killed a young dolphin.
Fish and Wildlife has a necropsy on a dolphin calf stranded on Fort Myers Beach, found its belly full of plastic waste. That pollution and a new push to eliminate it is your big story tonight at 6. Hi, I'm Krista Fogelsong.
And good evening, I'm Jeff Butera. Florida is one of the states where the push has been pretty hard to get rid of plastic pollution.
But as ABC 7's Rusty Matei reports, getting serious could mean cracking down on some long-standing traditions.
Well, we've all heard the myths about releasing plastic bags or balloons. Eventually, it's going to travel all the way to the ocean and hurt some of the wildlife in it. It turns out there is some truth to that. And tonight, some groups say we need to implement laws to prevent it.
For the first time tonight, we are seeing these new images from Florida Fish and Wildlife of a young dolphin that had to be euthanized after stranding itself on Fort Myers Beach.
It does make my heart break because it's, you know, it's a live animal and it's a friendly animal.
Inside that dolphin's stomach, investigators found two plastic bags and a piece of a balloon.
It's terrible. People shouldn't be polluting the ocean. They're pigs.
Pick up after yourself. Keep it clean and keep it clean for the people that come in after you, because that's just simple respect.
Animal experts at the Center for Rehabilitation of Wildlife say bags and balloons are particularly problematic because they look a lot like jellyfish.
A lot of the young animals who don't really know what prey is supposed to look like will ingest balloons.
Right now, it is not illegal to release a single balloon at the beach here in Florida, but we are one of just a few states that has laws preventing multiple balloons from being released. At least 10 of them could land you a $250 fine.
No garbage is okay. No litter is okay. It only takes one balloon to kill.
Danielle Vosberg founded the Florida nonprofit Balloons Blow. She blames balloon pollution on people, not a lack of laws.
Laws are important for sure, but we feel, you know, when people know better, they'll do better, whether there's a law or not.
She says it's more important for society to let go of the long-standing tradition of balloon releases.
Releasing balloons in the sky is really no different than tossing them on the ground, and most people wouldn't do that. So now that we're becoming aware of our impact, we can do better now that we know better.
And tonight, FWC can't say for sure whether it was the plastic bags and the balloon that ultimately caused that dolphin to strand itself here at Fort Myers Beach, but they are sending that plastic back to the lab to test and see. Reporting on Fort Myers Beach, Ross DeMattei, ABC 7.